Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Kalpana Kannan. I'm the project coordinator. And sorry for the audio problem in the video. So I think two people tried and still it didn't play well. So we'll see how to fix that. So I welcome you all to this live session of question and answer for English communication, both writing and written and oral. So we have with us Rama Kulkarni, Ritika Banerjee, and Shari. So they will be answering your questions live. And you can post your questions either through chat or you can come live. You can unmute yourself and you can ask questions. And this whole session is getting recorded. So we will make it available after the session. So please feel free to ask your questions now. And I have a couple of announcements before we proceed further. So I just want to tell you that we will be extending the course end date. Initially, it was mid of November, but now we are planning to extend it by one more month. So we will end the course only in middle of December. So that is a good news for many people who have joined late and who feel that they don't have enough time to complete the course. For them, they will have more time to finish all the assignments and quizzes. So that is a good news, but there is also a bad news for some people who want to get a certificate because they have to wait till the course ends. So they can get the official e-certificate only after the course ends, that is in middle of December. But in case somebody is very, they want to use this certificate for their employment or for showing it to somebody, so we can give a provisional certificate, but the e-certificate will, we cannot generate it before the course ends. So that is a problem, but we will give a provisional certificate in case somebody wants it urgently. So that is what I want to tell. And now, so if you have any queries, general queries, you can post it on chat. And also you can email us on two email IDs. That is eoutreach@it.iitb.ac.in or course support @iitbombayx.in. So with that, I hand over to Rama, Ritika, and Sharik. So they will take your questions. So I wish you all the best, and I hope you are all progressing well in your courses. So over to you, Rama and Ritika. Thank you all.
Thank you, ma'am. I'm just gonna give the video one last shot. If it doesn't work, then it doesn't work. I believe I can make it work with the presented tab option. One second. Are you guys able to see what I'm showing? Can someone just say yes?
Yes, we can.
But what is the difference between hearing someone speak and listening to them?
Sharik, the video
it is always advisable that you look up such words in a
sorry?
The video is not to be seen. It's just your screen, but there is no video there.
I could hear it in my end.
You could hear it, but not see it?
I can see it. I can see it. I can hear it.
I'll play it again, see if anyone can hear it.
You can infer the meaning of a word by its context, or even its.
Yeah, I'll do that. Yeah,
but what is the difference between hearing someone speak and listening to them? It is always advisable that you look up such words in a dictionary. Often, you can infer the meaning of a word by its context or even its structure. The English language also has a regular pattern of word and sentence stress. This is what gives the language its inbuilt rhythm. To infer means to make a logical conclusion, to understand something by applying logic to the given information. It is very important to make out word boundaries while listening. You must know where one word ends and another word begins. Words themselves carry shades of meaning, so it is important to use words carefully. Language reflects our own personality. Have you noticed how all the instructors in this course have different ways of speaking? Put in a nutshell, note making is jotting down important points from a lecture or a speech that we are listening to. Keep all numberings consistent. Introduce subcategories if required.
Notes are a concise form of the content that you have read.
Note that I said vowel sounds and consonant sounds.
Situations like this one can be avoided by understanding the difference between words that are pronounced in the same way but whose meanings and spellings may be different. Skimming basically means to read quickly as to grasp the main idea of the text. Scanning involves detailed, careful, and focused reading for the specific information desired.
We use full stops to end a sentence. Full stops of periods are also used in initials in some abbreviations. An apostrophe is used to indicate something or someone possesses or owns something or someone.
The apostrophe ought to be used when it stands for it is or it has. It should not be used when we say it's to show possession. The bird is flying away. What is the subject in this sentence? Think of the subject and the verb as pieces of a puzzle. Now the pieces need to be placed in one particular way for them to fit perfectly.
A sentence having a modal does not have infinitives.
If the word said is used, on the other hand, the tense of the sentence within the quotation marks will change to past tense.
Prepositions are also used to describe the way in which something is done. For example, we went by train.
Coherence or chronology in the presentation of the text is as important an aspect. Do not use contractions in academic writing as well. Use a good dictionary. Sometimes we cannot remember apt words and synonyms. In such case, use a thesaurus.
When Harry met his friend, he was very happy. In this sentence, you'd be confused about who the he refers to.
Do not try to fit too many words in a sentence, resulting in a long, winding and confusing sentence.
A common mistake that people make while writing is that they construct really long sentences that consist of too many phrases or clauses.
Pause and think before you press the send button. As emails speak on your behalf, choose your words appropriately to make a lasting impression.
It's the format, language used, and the purpose of the letter that differentiates it from an informal letter. The cover letter for your resume, application for leave, job application, and the complaint letter.
Native speakers of each of our languages might bring the influence of their own mother tongues to English.
English as a language can't be learned by making fun of others. Instead, we should encourage others to speak in English to learn it.
As they say, the best way to learn a language is to speak it.
Okay, so I shall take it ahead from here. Thank you, Sharik. Thank you so much. It was great that you could play the video, basically. Why was it so important to play that particular clip was because it gives in a nutshell what the whole course of oral and written communication is all about, what we have been doing, certain aspects that we have focused on. And we do not want you to miss out on either of the modules, be it either the oral or the written communication. So we are basically trying to insist that you you do both the courses hand in hand so as to help you in improving and helping learning a language. Well, we are, I think, good now to take your questions. Initially, I think we'll first take the live questions and then we can get down to, unless of course, you know, there are no live questions, we'll get down to a few which you've already sent us.
I guess we can use some of the questions in the chat while people think of other questions.
Yeah, I think that should be nice. Okay, Ritika is sweating, huh? So this whole snippet was her effort. We actually need to give her a round of applause.
Yeah.
you want to take the first question?
I'll answer this question. He says, will I need further books to improve grammar? So I just answer in the meanwhile. Either of you can take one of those questions.
So Vidya asked if this recorded video will be available for practice. I believe this video is recorded and it will be available to view later. If you meant to say if this particular video that we showed to you is available for practice, that video is basically an amalgamation or a combination of all the videos in our courses, and the link has already been placed in the chat by Ritika, so that is also available to you. It is a live interaction. We were just facing some technical problems. Vidya says, I'm facing problems developing arguments and making connections between two arguments, as well as choosing appropriate grammar during writing. So that's a tricky question. It is difficult to formulate arguments and make logical connections and select your words appropriately. This is something that comes with practice. Are you still on call with us, Vidya? Hello? Okay. I will just try and answer the question without input. Well, Vidya, basically, whenever we try and construct an argument, there has to be a logical flow. And that has something to do that is not really dependent on language. It is more dependent on the way you think. And what we need to do is make sure that there is a flow to whatever you're trying to see. Once you've figured out what the flow is, then it's about filling in the flow with the correct language. And that is when practice comes in. Once you're proficient enough in your language, you're automatically able to come up with words and sentences to articulate what you're trying to say. And yeah, the only thing I can tell you is to practice a lot, read a lot of books, try and see videos in which people try to develop arguments or make connections between two different points. Again, grammar is something that comes with practice, because it's syntactical. You need to understand how the different elements work together, how they join and work with each other. So my biggest takeaway from this is practice, unless Ritika or Amma can add something to it.
Okay, there is a question that was put up earlier which says, I need to improve my English fluency. Can I take up this question?
Yes, sir.
I can go ahead with it, right? Yeah. So, well, we have been focusing on the point that nothing comes easy. There are no shortcuts to success. You obviously need to give time. If you have gone thoroughly through the video where we have focused on fluency, one would realize that there are several practices that have been recommended to improve upon the fluency. You have to, of course, it all gradually develops. So basically listening carefully, not just hearing, you have to listen. We have already mentioned what is the difference between listening and hearing. So make sure that you listen to the words carefully. Make sure that they are woven together like a string, fit correctly in a sentence. Now, this is just understanding part as far as language is concerned. When it comes to fluency, what has been suggested by the teacher is you stand in front of a mirror and keep talking. You have to at least, make an effort so that you can at least know how you are performing. We have also been suggesting the fact that you should write down, and this is also mentioned in the video, that you can take up some incident in the day that has happened and you can write down. So basically writing dialogue in some sense. So supposing to say you had some kind of discussion with either a friend or in your class or wherever, and you can in that case you can pick up from there the discussion and see how differently you would have presented. So this is yet one of the ways in improving your fluency. Every time you come across a new word, we also suggest that, see, remembering all these words beyond a certain age is not very easy. So the best thing to do is to basically make a note of all these words somewhere, find out a meaning, and at the same time also find out the alternative words, because every time you can't be going back to the same dictionary or thesaurus. So pick up a thesaurus, find out alternative words that you can make use of in certain situations. So these are a few ways, of course, that you know, you can help yourself as far as fluency is concerned. All right, there was also yet another question which said that how to write journal papers without grammar mistakes. See, we have typically taken up more or less, you know, everything that a sentence structure requires. The only thing that we have not gone into the nitty-gritties of a verb, and but I think beyond that, so transitive, intransitive verb, and those things we have not, because the time did not permit. But well, we have, I think, suggested a book called Elements and Style in English. This is written by White and Strunk, and this is typically this is especially for the technical writings, you know. So every detail as far as commas, pauses, full stops, spacing, capital letters, abbreviations, everything is covered in this particular book. I would strongly suggest that you look into White and Strunk when it comes to dealing with grammar as far as technical writing is concerned. Okay, Ritika, would you want to take up the next question? In the meanwhile, yeah.
Okay. So there's a question that says, how to identify phrases and clauses? So like I've explained in the video, phrases don't consist of a subject and a verb, whereas clauses consist of a subject and a verb. That's basically the only difference. Now, subject is a doer of the action. So if I say I am talking, I am the subject and talking is the verb. So phrases are incomplete. It's like if I say a blue coat, that's a phrase, because here there's no, the subject and the verb aren't present. But clauses have both. So every time you read a sentence, just try to identify the subject and the verb, and you'll recognize if it's a phrase or a clause. Okay, then there's a question that asks, how to write professional communication letters? So I think you have to apply all the form, all the guidelines that we spoke about when I spoke about formal letters. You have to make sure that the subject is very brief, and yet like if you're applying for leave, you don't say I wish to apply for leave in the subject. Shouldn't be a full sentence. You say application for leave. So the subject should be brief. Even the body should be brief. You shouldn't give any personal details that's not required. You should stick to the point. And the language and tone should be very formal. So try to minimize the use of I and make it sound formal. And you'll get the hang of it once you send 2-3 letters. Also, I want to congratulate all of you. I've noticed that all of you have been participating a lot on the discussion forum. Even all the ungraded quizzes, all the letters, emails, you have been sending, and very good examples of writing. So that's a good thing. That's it. Are there any other live questions?
Ma'am, good afternoon, ma'am. I am Sajini Pradeep.
Ma'am,
first of all, let me thank you so much for your timely help and support, because what all we give, you know, emails and letters, corrections you are doing, okay, thank you so much for that, your timely help. And I have a doubt, you know, when a candidate gives reply to a job description letter he receives, yes, is there any subject required? Whether we should write any subject in that?
Job description letter, as in you are applying for a job?
When we are replying, subject required.
Yes, subject is required. You have to mention, so if you are applying for, say, the post of an assistant professor, you say application for post of assistant professor.
Ma'am, I have a doubt. This job description received means, is it already that appointment, like, is it like that? Actually, it is related with the activity, graded activity. One question is there in our. So in that, it is given job description letter received. A person received a job description letter. So is there any subject required?
Basically, what we have given in the graded assignment is the fact that you as a person has received a job description, and you can figure out what exactly your requirement, what the requirements of the jobs are, and you can then apply for a job. So whenever you're applying for a job and you're using a letter, a subject is required, because it clearly informs what the intent of your letter is. So let's say I'm applying for a job, but if I don't write subject, then the person who's reading the letter will be like, what is the letter? Why am I reading this? Why should I give my time in order to read the letter? The first thing someone does when they read a letter is look at the subject. And the subject tells them what the letter is about and why we need to read the letter. So there is marks for the subject. That was a good question.
Then one more thing. Is it a willingness letter or a confirmation letter actually?
What do you mean willingness?
Exactly mean by willingness?
That person is willing to join because he got the job description letter, so the person is willing to join. Is it like that?
Okay, Sharik, I'll take ahead from here.
Got it.
So, a subject line is very important in any kind of letter that you write, because in today's time when there is a time crunch, all right, what people do is, rather than reading the following paragraphs, how important is the letter, the subject basically focuses on that, and that is how they will pick up the letter. Okay, now when you are accepting the subject line, would say acceptance of the post offered for the whatever position that you had applied for. So it's an acceptance letter in that case then. When you are applying, it becomes an application letter basically. Then it becomes an acceptance letter.
Thank you. I got it. Thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you.
But then make sure that you do write the subject, because there is a time crunch and people do not have enough time to read through. Maybe in a particular setup, there are so many letters and emails that keep coming and going out, right? That you have to really prioritize what comes in, what is to be responded, at what urgency it is to be responded, and basically the subject line helps in these matters.
Okay, ma'am. Okay, thank you, ma'am. I understood. Okay, thank you.
All right. Yeah.
May I just add one more thing?
Letters and emails that you sent in. I noticed that you attempted all the ungraded activities.
Yeah.
Sajini, if I might add something, I just wanted to confirm that you understand what the question or the prompt is asking of you. Basically, what we are saying is that there is a job opening, you found the job description, and now you're applying for a job. You're not confirming a job that you offer that you have received. Remember, you're applying for a job. So that is different from accepting a job.
Okay.
Does that make sense?
Job application it is. Okay. Because
the job application.
Because you know something, you know, some doubt, confusion was there when I read that question. That is why.
Yeah, it's a little tricky. You have to read it 2-3 times. Even when I made the question, I realized the way I put it, you need to understand that you've received the job description and now you're using the job description to apply for the job.
Okay, so I got the confusion whether it is acceptance letter or we have to apply. Now it is clear, sir.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you so much. Thank you, Ritika ma'am, also.
Yeah, for your thank support. You, sir. Yeah. We appreciate you attempting all the assignments and being here today for the question answers. It speaks a lot on your part as well.
Okay, thank you. Thank you, ma'am.
Ma'am, may I ask some of the questions, please? Hello.
Yeah, please go ahead.
Yeah. Actually, my name is Ashish Shahunto. I am working as a database administrator in Calcutta University, one of the senior positions, that is about the professor position. But whatever I give the lecture, all this is okay. But whatever I think, whatever the journal I just read, the content is not so good. That is, the content is not so rich. So just my question is how to increase my vocabulary, how to increase the quality of the content. That is my question. But I know there is no shortcut method that by today or tomorrow everything will be all right. Okay, but what is the first way?
Okay, it basically depends upon how you present your matter. Okay, let us draw parallels now. Okay, when you decide to go for a presentation, it is your choice whether you want to wear a shirt, a t-shirt, a coat and a tie, right? You decide how is it that you're first of all going to present yourself, right? You give a thought to it, isn't that so? What will match with what, right? Now let's go on to the aspect of language, all right? When it comes to saying something, all right, you need to understand what is it that you're trying to tell them, all right? Now we have basically also given an example in the videos. See, we have already said do not use long binding sentences. Make sure that your sentences are short, they are terse, they are precise, they are to the point. You understand that, okay? Now these are the things that will basically help you. See, what happens is there is so much that you want to speak, right? But is the listener really interested, or is the reader really interested in reading all of that? You just heard me telling during the earlier question regarding the subject, right? The subject speaks for the letter. The same way when you're writing something, all right, you have to be terse, you have to be precise, so that you have to build up that curiosity in the reader so that he is willing to read further, right? So how is it that you would make? I have also mentioned about the chronology, right? So once you present it in a chronology, short sentences, to the point, the vocabulary may not be too rich or too complicated. It can be a simple sentence, all right? But if you can avoid repetition, all right? So these are a few things that, so all you need to keep thinking in your mind all the time. If this is what I have to tell him, what is the best way of constructing a sentence so that you are convincing? The use of language is basically convincing, right? When you're writing something, you're trying to convey. You're trying to hold someone's attention. You're trying to tell them something what you feel is right. Correct, no? Now, if you have to do that, all of that has to reflect in those words. So when it comes to face-to-face speech, it's a different ballgame. When you're writing, it's a different ballgame altogether. Okay, so give yourself time, try to revise and try to write as much as possible in different ways. Okay, so what you could do is you could understand what is an active and passive sentence. Try and look up into what is active and passive, what are active and passive sentences. You basically swap the position of the subject and the object. All right. She called me. I was called by her. Ask yourself what sounds best. Ask yourself, is this what you want to tell? So generally, when it comes to writing, you use the active voice because that is direct. Passive voice is typically indirect, right? So these are small, small things. Once you understand these things, all right? So list a few things from, see, that is basically what the takeaway is from those videos. All right, there are, and that is the reason why we made that small snippet, you know, of 4 minutes, 5 minutes, wherein, you know, these are the, as you would have also gathered, it speaks your personality. Language speaks your personality, right? So what is it that you're trying to tell about your personality in that case then, right? Keeping in mind the subject that you have to take up, how is it that you would present it? Okay.
Thank you.
Yes. Are you satisfied?
One more thing. Yeah. Nowadays, I'm just facing one more problem that the since last 15 years, I'm in service with the technical officer. So some known spelling. Now, whenever I go for writing, I do some mistakes. Because in the earlier in the student life, I know the spelling. Because due to some Google Depth or something like that, yeah, that is the general habit. Okay. Okay, Google Hana, okay, that will make correct. Yeah. Okay, that is the problem. So, do you have some advice regarding that?
Google Hana. Yeah, basically, the more you read, the more your eyes can see the spelling, okay, and the more you understand the context in which it is being used. Okay, I think that it's all about practice. It's not that we don't go wrong on spellings. Okay, let me shamelessly accept that. And as you rightly said, it is Google that fixes. You know, it's a quick fix, right? So we don't give a thought, too much of a thought. Okay, so when you're using, let me give you example of a small example of necessity. How many C's and how many S's? Right? Okay. And that is where we tend to go wrong. I absolutely understand. But the more you come across these words, all right, again and again, it helps. Okay. So just make sure that, you know, your reading is enough so that you minimize on your, so pick up a newspaper, you know, I mean, if there is not much time to take anything else, or when you're reading something on, online, whichever ways, you know. So these are a few things which will probably help you as far as spellings are concerned.
Also, when you're reading, take that extra effort to look up a dictionary, whatever difficult word. Because when you look up a dictionary, that spelling also stays in your mind.
Okay. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you for your
time. Yeah, yeah. Thanks. Yeah.
Any other questions, people? Please speak up. Okay, while we wait, oh, sorry. Go ahead, Ritika.
No, I was saying, I think Vidya Sharma missed your answer. She's asked the same question.
Oh, right. Rama, do you want to take it?
Which one?
The making arguments, constructing, connecting to arguments and fluency.
Okay, okay. How to enhance better fluency for, the connection, one sentence to another.
I think Vidya missed my answer. I tried to ask if Vidya was on call. Vidya, are you on call right now?
Vidya Sagar Kumar.
Okay, beyond that, there was a question regarding watching movies. I will be, of course, I agree with what Ritika says. You should, of course, watch movies that can help. Movies, videos, TED Talks, these are a few things that definitely helped in understanding of the language of speech as such. But beyond this, if you also make a small attempt of maybe writing a paragraph so that whatever you have understood, you have summarized and put it in a paragraph, just a small story or storyline, whichever way that one can do, it can definitely be helpful. So Jitendra, I think, has asked this question, right? So if you are there, Jitendra, just make sure that after watching something, you summarize it. This is just for your benefit, and it should help you.
That's a useful
link. Yeah, most people, especially I remember when I was in school, TED Talks were a very new thing to me. And TED Talks are something that most people still don't know what they are. Basically, yeah. For the benefit of everyone here who does not know TED Talks, they're basically inspirational, motivational, or informational videos about prominent speakers talking on important subjects. It could be anything from science, technology, innovation, medicine, poetry, arts, literature, or
to our example, industry, you name it.
Yeah, anything. Yeah. And so our example is pertaining to the English language and how to learn the English language, how to get fluent, how to get adept. So that's just one link. You can always Google TED Talk for English language learners on Google, and it will throw up so many videos at you.
Okay.
Netflix can also help you with communication, vocabulary, and fluency, but you need to be very careful with Netflix because Netflix has a lot of informal content. And if you try and apply that to a formal scenario with jobs, that can create confusion because you'll start using colloquial language, you'll start using contractions, you'll start using slangs, and that is not going to help you with jobs or a formal setting. So Netflix will help you with your friends. Netflix will help you with overall fluency, yes. Maybe appearing smart when you're talking eventually. But you want to be able to learn English formally in order to be able to use it formally.
I think this applies to movies as well. If you just see which context it is and what context you're talking
to, you apply. Yeah, that's very true. Also, NVK Sharma, you should speak up. I mean, don't be shy. If you believe you're not saying things right, this is non-judgmental space. Everyone makes mistakes. So go ahead, speak up. If you feel like you're making a mistake, we'll correct you. And then you can learn from your mistakes. So this applies to most people. Anyone who has a question, please speak up. You can use a chat box if you're conscious, but try and speak up so that we can gauge your level and we can actually help you out.
Oh, sorry, the network snapped, so I had
no worries. Hello, sir.
So this was regarding Netflix. Just one sec, Vijay. My only request is depending, it all depends upon the kind of matter you choose to watch. Okay, just make sure that it is not too violent because it might reflect on your understanding of the language. See something which is nice, sober. We are learning a language. We are not trying to invade anyone in the next few years or whatever it is. Okay, so just be that little careful.
Yes, Vijay.
Sir, like I don't have much source to speak English. Like my family members or friends don't speak English. So what can I do to solve this issue?
Start writing emails to people. Find an internet buddy. A lot of people do this whenever they're learning a new language. You find someone to communicate with online and then you speak to that person. I remember doing this, or I remember friends who did this in school for Spanish. I think the same thing can apply to English. If you can't find anyone, just write emails to us. We will respond to you. Keep you can drop in a little hello and a hi, try and introduce yourself, try and summarize your day or your week, send it to us, we'll try and respond and pick it up from there. If we are not available, try and, I'm quite sure there are websites, we'll try and, I'll try and look up something and send a link. But that is an important thing. As long as you have access to the internet, is a very powerful resource and you can make the most of it. You can try and find someone to communicate with online. And apart from that, you can always keep practicing on the side on your own, use the mirror, but it's not a substitute for the real thing. As you rightly said, you need someone to speak to because it's a form of communication and you need to someone to communicate with. So find people online to talk to. I'm quite sure you have Facebook or WhatsApp or something. Try and reach out to people who are not near you and try and speak to them. Make new friends online. Be careful while making friends. And yeah, I guess that's the most important piece of advice I have to give you.
Sir, actually, I text or communicate in English, like on chatting in English, but I want to ask about speaking, like speaking practice.
Okay. Vijay, can you also do this? I have also been suggesting this since last year. There are small things that we tend to do in our daily routine. All right. So the point is, today before you joined in, rather than telling yourself that, you know, in your mother tongue that you have to join this, all right, you could say, oh, there is a 3 o'clock meeting and I need to join that. What I'm asking you to do is talk to yourself. If you find it difficult to communicate with others, maybe, you know, oh, I need a glass of water. I'm feeling a bit thirsty. Right? So these small sentences, if you start constructing in your mind and keep telling yourself, I'm sure this will also help you. So, so this is yet one of the ways of, you know, when it comes to speech.
And just say it out loud. Remember, like, as Rama mentioned, you have to get a glass of water. And you think about it in your mother tongue. Say it out loud in English to yourself, softly. You don't have to scream it out, but like, oh, I need to get a glass of water. I need to get a cup of water. Small things like that will reinforce your language. And eventually you'll be able to think in English.
Okay, sir, I get it. Thank you, sir.
And other than that, always, if you make an internet buddy, apart from texting and apart from emailing and chatting, you will be able to set up voice calls and video calls with them as well. Eventually, once you have trusted that person, once you know that person is legitimate and is actually there to learn from you, there are websites and portals you can use or utilize. Look them up online.
Okay, sir.
Okay. Thank you, Vijay, for your question.
Thank you, sir.
Hello, ma'am, sir. Basically, I'm a school teacher, so I'm observing this NEP multidisciplinary approach. A lot of changes are coming in 21st century skills. So I'm from Chinese school, so I want to give a lot of awareness to the students to use in a proper way. I mean, even the writing, especially the students are very good in informal language. That's because they may communicate easily. But a lot of grammatical mistakes will be there. When it comes to formal writing, they are not up to the mark. So if we suggest some activities, so I want to suggest them something interesting so that they can pick up, so that they will be useful communication and oral communication and written communication useful. That's why I'm enrolled in this course, so that I want to suggest something. So I want to give some input, sir and ma'am. Please could you suggest me something to school children like 6 to 12 classes?
I think Renan Martin is a good book for school children. It deals with the basics and yet is simple to understand.
Okay, what I personally feel is this is a very a nice question that you have asked. Very few teachers realize that the way students speak and the way they write, there's a world of difference. Okay, so formal writing is very difficult and informally when you speak, all right, you don't tend to make many mistakes, and that is the reason why students are under the impression that they know the language. Okay, there are a few activities that one can carry out. You can basically ask them to have dialogues, maybe, you know, ask them to create a podcast. Okay, now when you are creating a podcast, it is not just talking, you have to write the dialogues. And when it comes to writing the dialogues and then looking at them and then speaking, all right, that will help them to minimize the mistakes that they make. This is just one activity that I can suggest. There are other activities also where you can ask them to involve. So asking them to watch a movie and then asking them to write a review of it. You will probably have to give them titles on the basis of the on what you would examine the review. Same is true of a book as well. You know, ask them to read, say, a small text of Ruskin Bond, or a small story from Rabindranath Tagore, or even, in fact, any small story you can ask them to read and give their reviews on it. So once you make them write something, they realize that there are grammatical mistakes that can be avoided, you know. So I don't know, see what suits you. Letter writing and emails can, beyond a point, be boring, I understand, for school students as such, because again, you know, when there is this impression that we are good as far as language is concerned. Okay, so I hope that answers your question. Okay, can we move on to Jitendra? Jitendra Gautam, I think you are wanting to ask something.
Hi Vidya, while we wait on Jitendra, I'll quickly try and answer your question. So how can I do plenty of practice to get familiar in appropriate writing skill in formal writing? Is there any tutorial available for gradually improving writing in basic level? So this is again something that
Tariq, there is a question on sound which was asked, and I want to answer that question.
Sure. Go ahead. I'll do it in the chat.
No. You can just tell her. It's absolutely fine. Quickly answer her question so that I can go to sounds then.
Yeah, the only thing I was going to... Yeah, go ahead, Ritika.
Has he enrolled for the written communication course? Vidya Sagar? Or is it
right? That would be the first step, Vidya. Enroll in a written communication course. Shameless plug, use our course. It's a really good one. You will be able to systematically practice your writing. There are written assignments, there's a graded assignment. And all I was going to say was use online courses as a medium of a tutorial to gradually improve your writing skills, because there are peer graded assignments, there are course graded, staff graded assignments, and over time you can learn really well. So yeah, just use online courses. They are a really powerful tool. They're free for most part, and if they're paid, it's a very nominal charge. So go ahead, use online courses.
All right. I feel that this is quite an interesting question on sounds. The question says, the sound of English, the sub-module, was felt difficult. Any extra tips to overcome and identify the sounds of English? I definitely understand and I agree that for a first-timer who is trying to learn sounds from the videos that we have basically provided here will be a little difficult. It can also get a bit tedious because it just goes on and on, okay? And you're not mentally prepared for those sounds. But it was felt essential to mention those sounds because what we have realized is that one tends to, one think in their mother tongue, and the influence of their mother tongue on the language per se as well as on the speech was rather heavy. There are times when it becomes very difficult for others to understand what is being said. And that is the reason why the module on sounds was introduced. Okay. The next part of the question is there any way or method to ease, okay, to understand how these sounds? So the best way to understand the sound is when you go to a dictionary, online dictionary, there is a small mic ka icon. When you press on that icon, it gives you the option as to how the word is to be spelled, how you should speak that word. I think that is the closest that we can come. The only thing is there are two options as far as the speech is concerned. One is the British English and the other is the American English. We typically go in for the British English. The RP pronunciation is what they call it. So make sure that you choose the RP pronunciation. You choose English into brackets UK pronunciation. That helps a lot. And make yourself, put yourself into the habit of listening to the way the word is articulated. Okay, so that you are not ridiculed when you speak certain words. Okay, so yeah, so this I felt was a very nice and important question to be answered. Yeah.
Rama, I wanted to ask, are we short on time or can I make an announcement?
Yeah, you can make an announcement.
So guys, I'm not entirely sure about the oral communication course, but I know for the written communication course, we have a graded assignment that's worth around 40% of the grade. That means if you believe your quizzes have not gone well and you still want your certificate, I strongly, strongly recommend you attempt the graded assignment. It might look challenging at first, but all it is a job application and a convincing email to someone. So that you can get your job, so that you can get your appointment, you can get the job that you need. And I've noticed that while a lot of people have attempted the quizzes, not a lot of people have attempted the graded assignment. Don't put it off till the end. It is very, very easy to say, once the deadline comes, I'll write something and I'll submit it in. Send it in now, so that there's plenty of time for you to get feedback on it and put in some thought behind it. That's very, very easy. That's very, very important. So remember to attempt the graded assignment, guys. Guys, any other questions?
Hello, sir. Hello.
Yep.
Yeah, yeah. Here is Satishan. And sir, I have completed my work on the oral communication, and now I'm doing this written communication. You know, what I have felt when I was going through with each module, and some of the modules for the video sessions, after the video sessions, when I was trying to solve the questions in the graded quizzes, I felt that the explanation part, which has covered only the basics part, basic level, whereas the questions were at the highest level. This kind of one experience, I mean, I was experiencing that thing. So therefore, I could not perform in a better way as they expected earlier. So is there any solution for this? Because almost 80% of the work is completed and only 20% is left out.
Okay, right. So okay. I feel like, go ahead, Rama.
I just wanted to congratulate Satishan. He was there with us during the last meet also. And I'm really glad that you could finish the first part. I remember you asking me a question on fluency. Am I right?
Yeah.
And fluency was something that you had asked. Are you satisfied? Are you happy with what you did?
Yeah, it's fine. Thank you.
Okay. All right. Now, your question is that the lessons are at a lower level and the exercises at the higher level. Is that what you're trying
to say? Yes. Actually, as it suggested that IIT Bombay.
Okay. I don't think there was anything of this because it's a basic course. I don't think, I'm a bit surprised that you felt that the course was at a basic level and the exercises that were asked were at a very higher level. We basically have been trying to just include what is being taught. There has been thing over and above that we have asked. Manage to take help from a dictionary, manage to take help, keep going back to the videos. It could have been difficult. It could have been possible that there are certain concepts that you did not get and you read the questions, I think going back and forth should also help in some sense.
I think the feeling that way also because our questions are more application based, whereas the videos teach you the concepts.
Yes, exactly. This is what I experienced exactly.
Right.
So I was thinking that yes, how would it be possible for me to do it with that level of questions. Then I was thinking that yes, I had to go back but there was no chance when a person has already completed the graded assignments and it was already graded. Then I felt it was a hurdle for me to, there is a constraint for me to go back and do once again. Madam, please.
Yeah, I think, leave aside this whole thing about grading, marks, certificate. All right. I would rather, on a very personal level also, suggest that you rise above this and make sure that it helps you further your purpose when it comes to applying whatever you have learned. So keep looking on the net also. I mean, I wouldn't strictly say that the videos are the only way of learning, okay? Keep looking at find some alternatives also online, and I'm sure you would that will help you.
Yes. But one more query.
Yes.
After I have uploaded the letter writing and email in the written communication module, after that I just tried to see my grade, and could you please tell me that yes, this is this having evaluated, and after that the grade has been shown.
Sorry, I didn't get to that.
There is a particular module in the written communication in which we have to upload some assignments, like written assignments. One is that is a letter writing, and the other is email. So both the things have completed, and I uploaded both the things. And after that, as suggested, I just tried to see my grade. So then I got a doubt that is whether it has been shown the grade just based on those things which were marked and except the uploaded contents.
I believe I will just check up on the system as I'm talking to you right now.
Are you talking about the written assignment and not the ungraded exercises?
There is a little bit of fear that yes, whether we will read, I'm speaking about myself, whether I'll read the minimum requirement of certification. This is what I am a bit apprehensive about.
So I do see your assignment up here, and I also see that we haven't graded it yet. So are you scared about when we do grade it, whether or not you will receive the certificate?
Okay, sir. Thank you very much, sir. It's very nice to have a discussion with you all. Thank you.
Have you attempted all the other graded quizzes, Satish?
Madam, please.
Have you attempted all the graded quizzes?
No, only 1% is left out. All other things were completed, and the written communication, oral communication is already completed, and just last week itself. And now, from last week to this week, I was carrying out with this one, written communication, and we 80% is complete, and only very little part is left out. But anyway, I'm constantly looking at those things and capturing each and every idea which I have got. It is very helpful.
Okay, then don't worry about the certificate.
Okay. Yeah. Now that you mentioned, we will definitely look into this, and we know that you're putting your all into it. So we will also make sure we give you as much feedback as possible. So don't worry about the grade. Be really, really mindful of the feedback we give you and incorporating that feedback so that you can improve your English.
Yeah, sure, sir. I am actually this for the purpose of improvement, and still, mind will be always what is it, just curious about the thing, whether the
right. Case is, no, of course, I would be curious as well if I was in your case. You will get. We will try and grade it before the deadline. If not, you'll definitely have it by the deadline. So keep an eye out for your grade, and yes, make sure you incorporate the suggestions that we give it. Okay.
Yeah. Thank you, sir.
No worries.
I think we have jumped time by 10 minutes. It's time that we wrap up. I'm sure that the next course has to also be addressed. So should we wind up as of now?
Works fine by me. Kalpana ma'am?
Yeah. I think if there are no more questions, then we can wind up because the next session starts at 4:15. Thank you all for joining, and thank you, Rama, Deepika, and Tariq for answering all the questions patiently, and I really appreciate.
Thanks.
So if you have any further questions regarding the subject, I request all of you to post it on the discussion forum. So if you have subject related queries, you should post it on discussion forum. And if you have any administrative related queries, you can send the email to coursesupport@iitbombayx.in. So that is our email ID where you can ask any administrative related questions. But all course related questions, you should always post it on the discussion forum. So please use discussion forum actively. Thank you all. So we'll meet again next month. And I suggest that all of you should try to finish whatever graded assignments as early as possible. But the course will be open till middle of December. We are extending it by one more month because many of the college students have joined late and they have registered. In fact, even now we are getting some registrations. So that's why we have to extend the course by one more month so that many people can benefit during this COVID time. So I hope you'll understand our situation and cooperate with us. So because of this e-certificate distribution will be delayed. Like you have to wait till the course ends, that is in the middle of December. But if somebody wants the certificate urgently, then maybe we can provide a provisional certificate. So that will be only for fewer number of students, not to everybody. You have to explain like why you want the certificate, and then we will see whether we can provide the provisional certificate. So that's all from me. So thank you all for joining, and I wish you all the best for the course. Thank you. Bye.
Thank you.